Welcome to the short tutorial on installing Lansweeper. This video covers the advanced install. Performing an advanced install is recommended if one or more of the following is true. You have a network with more than 1,000 assets. You want to install a database under Microsoft SQL Server. You want to spread out the Lansweeper service, database, and web console over several machines. You want to configure an installation with multiple scanning servers. Let's start the installation. First things first, download the latest installer from our website, lansweeper.com, and run it on the Windows computer you want to install Lansweeper on. Hit the Next button. Make sure you go over the license agreements and hit I agree to accept and continue the installation. Select the Advanced Install option. In this video, we will be installing Lansweeper under a free version of SQL Server. Make sure you manually set up the SQL Server instance prior to running the Lansweeper installer. If you want to spread out the components, select a component you wish to install on this machine. For example, if you have a dedicated database server, you can choose to only install a new Lansweeper database. Afterwards, you can install the Lansweeper scanning server and web console on another machine. In this video, we will install all the Lansweeper components on the same machine with SQL Server as the database type. Select the components you wish to install and hit Next to proceed. Submit the name of the SQL Server instance under which you want to install the Lansweeper database. Type in the same instance name you're using to log into other SQL tools like Management Studio. Additionally, choose your preferred authentication method. You can select either Windows authentication or SQL Server authentication. If you choose SQL Server authentication, please submit your SQL username and password. This user, which is only used once to create a new Lansweeper SQL user and database, must be a member of the sysadmin server role. Once the installation is done, sysadmin rights are no longer required as only the new created SQL user has access to the Lansweeper database. In this case, we will select Windows authentication, which will install the Lansweeper database under the currently logged on Windows user. Hit Next to continue. If you're installing the Lansweeper web console, select the web server under which you want to install the console. Selecting Recommended will install the web console under IIS Express. If IIS is not yet present on the machine, it will be installed automatically. Selecting Advanced will install the web console under IIS. The Advanced option will only be available if IIS is already enabled on your computer. The web console will automatically be installed under the first available ports, but you can choose custom ports as well. Hit Next to proceed. Optionally, you can choose a custom folder to install Lansweeper under. Hit Install to proceed, which will install Lansweeper database under SQL Server of your choice, and the web console under the web server service of your choice. If you want to receive the latest Lansweeper news, solutions, and updates, enter a name and email address to subscribe to our newsletter. Hit Finish to close the installer. Once installed, you can access the web console by double-clicking the Lansweeper desktop icon. You'll be presented with the first run wizard, which allows you to set up scanning and configure some basic options. These settings can always be adjusted later. By default, Lansweeper will automatically detect the IP range in which you are currently located. You can submit a different IP range if required. Hit Next to continue. Using domain or workgroup scanning, Lansweeper will scan the Windows computers as they come online. It also scans domain users configured in Active Directory. Hit Next to proceed. Lansweeper uses administrative credentials to access and pull data from your computers. It is important to note that your credentials are always encrypted and stored locally. Lansweeper never sends them across the network or internet. Your credentials must have admin privileges on your computers, and for scanning domain computers and users, read only access to Active Directory. Hit Next to continue. For scanning network devices such as printers and switches, enter an SNMP community string. The default string is public, which is commonly used by network devices for read-only access, but can be different for your network. Hit Next to proceed. If you will be scanning Linux, Unix, or Mac computers, enter an SSH username and password. Hit Next to continue. If you have any VMware servers in your network, enter a username and password with read-only access to the Managed Object Browser. Hit Next to proceed. Select the date format you'd like to use throughout the Lansweeper web console and hit Finish. At this point, Lansweeper will automatically start scanning your network. Hit Continue to immediately proceed to the web console while scans are taking place in the background. The results from your initial discovery can be consulted by clicking Assets in the top menu. Click on a specific asset to catch a glimpse of the information Lansweeper was able to retrieve. but this is just the tip of the iceberg. Ready to get started? You will find more information below to help you set up Lansweeper and discover everything it has to offer. Check out these other videos and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.